What the hell is a phthalate? Why is it dangerous and how do I pronounce it? And so I've already given the third part of the question away, but basically phthalate, which is P-H-T-H-A-L-A-T-E, yes, is pronounced phthalate. It's like the silent p. It's a very strange word. So it's a softener for plastics. You find it in things like PVC, and it's been linked to birth defects, obesity, asthma, reproductive problems, a whole host of things. So in 2008, Congress permanently banned three types of phthalates, that's DEHP, DBP, and BBP. So you're not gonna see those on a label, but I'm just throwing those out there because I'm reading them on my screen. Anyway, they banned them from anything greater than 0.1% in anything kids put in their mouths, basically like toys and feeders and teethers and all that stuff, which is great. But there's a lot of other stuff that kids put in their mouths and that we have in our environments that include phthalates that we could avoid. So one way to avoid them is to stay away from anything. If you like flip over a cosmetics bottle and it says fragrance, typically that means artificial fragrance, which is typically has phthalates in it. So if it's a really, even like natural fragrance on the label can sometimes mean artificial fragrance. In fact, it usually does. Usually when a fragrance is truly natural, it will list what it is. So like essential oil of lavender is a natural fragrance, does not include phthalates. And that's what you want to look for if you want to avoid them. Another way to avoid them is to avoid products that are made from PVC, which is vinyl. Anything that has like a, you know, that says vinyl on it or it has a three on the bottom of it, like, you know, the chasing arrow symbol that you look at when you're looking at a plastic container it has on the bottom. So flip it over. If it says three, that means it's PVC, and you want to avoid that if you want to avoid phthalates. So phthalates are part of PVC, but PVC has some other things that you might want to avoid in it. Sometimes it's known as the poison plastic, and that's because it contains lead and cadmium. It leaches dioxin, which is a known carcinogen, and it was recently linked to diabetes, which is a condition that affects 25 million Americans. I had no idea when I read that statistic on my screen. No, I read it before. I wrote it on my screen, but I read it before. Anyway, so the other thing about PVC is that it's not recyclable. Yet, it looks the same as other plastics. So like PET, for example, which is a safer and recyclable plastic, looks the same as PVC unless you turn it over and you look at what number it is. But if you throw one of those PVC bottles into a recycling facility, it will contaminate up to 1,000 PET bottles so that you can't even recycle them. So that sucks, right? So there's some great online guides for avoiding PVC. One of them that I really love is from the Center for Health, Environment, and Justice. You can see the URL there. And they basically tested a whole bunch of back-to-school products like backpacks and lunchboxes and folders and all kinds of stuff. And they found the ones that contain phthalates, typically made from PVC, and they listed those. And then they also listed some that are really safe and great alternatives. So I love that. Because honestly, the next time you're packing your kids' lunch, do you really want to pack a side of phthalates with that sandwich? I didn't think so. Anyway, so tweet me more questions at Rachel L. Sarnoff, and I will see you here every Friday. Thanks.